Okay, so this was what we are left with. So we did handling screen rotation in the previous session. Anyone has any doubts on this? Okay, what about others? Abhishek, have you done this? Like, did you practice? Okay, so now, today what we will do, we will look up how to use Android resources and how to use raw data types. This in Android, till now we have used rest folder, rest directory to define resources. Now we would be going to use a media player resource. Okay, now our media player resource, it takes an data of raw type. Like in Android, the music or any video that we have to play, we store it in a folder called raw, that is stored under the rest directory. So let's just open the last application that we were working on yesterday. This is the application on which we work. We would continue with the same, and later on we would change to our score application and do the code over there. Okay, so this is a preview of our application. We have one button, on click of which we were changing some text. Now let's just add some media that would be playing on click of the same button. So here is the code for set on, like BTN, BT1 dot set on click listener V. And then the onClick method. Now guys, in order to have a media player, we need to define a resource type that is media player and an instance of this. Let's write it media player. Okay. Now, first of all, we would go to rest, and here we need to add one more resource directory. So let's go to new, add a resource directory. Directory type is values. Just change the type to raw. Now it is raw and source set main. Click OK. You got one more directory here, that is raw. Just go to this library and show it in Explorer. Now this library is available to you in your Explorer. Now your task is just copy any music file. And paste that file into your raw folder. Now I have one MP3 file. Let's just name it accordingly. Our name should not contain any capital letter. Let's write it DUP or music file. Okay, and let it be like this, music file. Now here, when we are clicking the button, we should allot the media player with some memory. So it would be like media player. Equal to new media player, and now it takes an argument that is android.media. So what we have to do, r dot raw dot music file. Okay, now we have instantiated our media player. Now we need to just allot our music file to the media player, and we have to set the play method that would play our media. But there is one small mistake that I've created, like that I've committed for media player. When we are doing it, we do not take new media player. What we do, we have to create the resource. In order to create the resource, we need to call create method of our media player class. So we will do it like media player equal to media player dot create, and it would take our first context, then we would give it this, or let's give the activity context. Main activity dot this. Then we have to pass the URI or the resource ID. Simply we can use this also. I did not understand what you are saying. Yeah, no, Yashika, if we use instead of no main activity dot this, if you simply use this, the context of this button would be passed, because the onclick listener is working on the button. We are on instance of this button, so yahan pe button ka hi instance pass hoga, activity ka instance nahi pass hoga. So now we have to pass the resource ID, that is r dot raw dot music file. Okay, once we are done with this, now we have created our media player, and it has acquired the resource on our music. Now what we would do, we would call some methods that would start our media player or that would stop our media player. Now guys, in order to start the play of media or media player, what we have to do, we have to just call media player dot start. This would start the playback. Now we have this. Let's just run the application and see what is happening. Okay, now so let's just wait for some more minutes. It is waiting for target device to come online. Now you can see the device is coming online. So let's just wait and see what happens. In the meantime, if anyone have any doubt in any of the topics, then you can just ask it. Okay, so our application is here in on start, on create, and on resume. There is some text. Here are, let's say, our check boxes which we have checked. Then our radio buttons. Now guys, when I clicked this, guys, was the audio of that track, was it audible to you all? Okay, so it was audible to you. So you would have noticed. Let me play that again. Let's open the application again. Main app, my application. Okay, everyone, just notice that what are the callbacks and how the audio is responding. Here is our text view. Here's the name. Now, when we play on this button, okay, now this audio that just came, it was not from our media player, it was from like some other resource. Now, when we click on button, the music started playing. We are in on resume state. Okay, let's just do it. It's not like it's not returning the state to us. Anyways, we were in on resume state of the activity callback. Now let's just close this application. When we close, when we click this button, it's in on pause, on stop, and on destroy. Like our activity has destroyed, but the music is still playing. Now this audio file will keep on playing unless we just terminate the application. Or the second thing is the music will play until the like the song has stopped. Like एक बार ये सॉन्ग खत्म हो जाएगा, फिर वो चलना बंद करेगी, या वो चलती ही रहेगी. इट इज लाइक इट जस्ट कीप्स ऑन प्लेइंग. बट वी डू नॉट नीड दैट बिकॉज इट इज जस्ट वेस्टिंग आर रिसोर्स. हमने एक बार एप्लीकेशन जब बंद कर दिया, एक्टिविटी डिस्ट्रॉय कर दी, नाउ वी डोंट नीड द म्यूजिक टू प्ले. तो वॉट वी डू इन आवर ऑन डिस्ट्रॉय मेथड, वी जस्ट कॉल अनदर मेथड दैट इज मीडिया प्लेयर डॉट डिस्ट्रॉय. And in order to destroy our media player, the term we use is to release, because we need to release all the resources that are attached with our media player. So we would call the method media player dot release. Now, what this method will do, जब भी हम अपनी एक्टिविटी के ऑन डिस्ट्रॉय कॉल बैक में जाएंगे, तो जो भी मीडिया का रिसोर्स है, it would just release all the resources from our media player. Now let's just check what is the impact of this line. हमने रिसोर्स हटा दिया तो उससे क्या होगा. ओके, देर वुड बी एन एरर. सुपर शुड बी द फर्स्ट लाइन ऑफ कोड. एड इट हियर. Now the application is running. Let's just click the button. Open the log cat. Now it's playing subset subtitle anchor in media player and all. It's like media player is working here. Now let's just close the button. Jaise hi on destroy call hua, what happened? Our music stopped because humne apne on destroy ko we had given a line that was release the media player resources. Now guys, yet abhi bhi hum kya kar rahe hain, humne isko media player ko ek resource allocate kiya, usne ek music file ke liye ek resource banaya, then we started playing the song and in on destroy we are releasing it. Now releasing the media player would abruptly close, would abruptly release the media resources, so that jo media player hoga wo file se apna control lose kar dega. Now when it loses the control, then it would lose all the information about the media, like isne ek song ko kitna play kiya tha, and all those things, kis speed pe play ho raha tha, what was the playback speed, what was the volume that was decided to play it, ye sara information bhul jayega. And also it would like and when we like try to restart it, it would just go and restart the entire media file playback again. So what we should do, before media player dot release, we should first like stop playing our media. And to stop playing the media, we call a method media player dot start. Now one more use case, this is our application. This is not that application. This is our application. The moment we click button, our music is started. We are here. We have written button clicked. Again, we are clicking. What would happen? जितनी बार हम क्लिक कर रहे हैं, वी कैन सी यहाँ पे एक मीडिया प्लेयर का रिसोर्स उसको एलोकेट हो रहा है, एलोकेट हो रहा है, एलोकेट हो रहा है. लेट्स डू इट अगेन एंड वन मोर मीडिया इज स्टार्टिंग. नाउ वी आर इन ऑन डिस्ट्रॉय. हमारा एक रिसोर्स तो बंद हो रहा है. नाउ व्हाट वी हैड, वी हैव मल्टीपल रिसोर्सेज, सो ऑल ऑफ देम डिड नॉट स्टॉप. So what we need to do, we need to check if media, if there is no other media player resources allocated to our application, in that case only we should allocate the resource. Now here again, when we start a media player, it just starts playing. Close it. Now it closed, but in previous use case what we saw, ye close nahi wala, because one instance is closing but there are more instances. Now we can check it if media player dot is playing. Now is playing method, it returns to us a boolean value that corresponds to the state of media player. Is it playing or is it not? If it is playing, what we can do, media player dot stop, otherwise what we have to do, media player dot start. Now this button is configured just like the play button of our media players or our music players. व्हाट वी डू, हम एक बटन पे क्लिक करते हैं, म्यूजिक स्टार्ट होती है, उसी बटन पे हम दोबारा क्लिक किया, म्यूजिक बट इट इज लाइक when our media player is playing, it did not stop it. Now, just to look for appropriate methods, what we need to use, what we can do, we can just go to developers.android.com and the media player documentation over there, and we can just check what are the available methods for media player and how they would behave for us. So everyone just open the web browser and open media player. This is the media player overview. Now here, this is the class, the media player class. This class is the primary API for playing sound and videos. Now it says manifest declaration. If you are using media player to stream network based content, we should use internet permission. If our application needs to keep the screen from dimming or the processor from sleeping, then we should use like media player dot set screen while playing. We should be using the wake lock permission. Now we come to using media player resources. It has three options. The first is local resource. We can play the music from our application's resource. That was local resource that we just performed. It takes internal URIs that we can get from content resolver, or we can get from intents. Like hamari file manager mein, file mein koi media player pada hua hai. Aur wahan se humne हिट किया एक फाइल के नाम पे. सपोज देर वॉज MP3 फाइल इन आर फाइल एक्सप्लोरर, वी क्लिक्ड इट एंड द मीडिया एंड इट स्टार्ट्स प्लेइंग. दैट इज द सेकंड यूज केस. देन द एक्सटर्नल यूआरएल, वी आर टेकिंग सम अदर रिसोर्स, लाइक वी आर स्ट्रीमिंग इट फ्रॉम द इंटरनेट. नाउ वी नीड टू सेव आर ऑडियो फाइल्स इन /raw डायरेक्टरी. This is how we start it. Media player dot create, then media player dot start. Now, what we can see, these are some other methods to define the URI. Like when we are using, when we are trying to play and locally system based URIs that we are getting from a content resolver or we get from any intent, then we would be having our URI that we are getting from content, then media player equal to new media player. Then we set the audio stream type, like we are streaming in music or we are streaming in video. Then we pass it the data source, like our URI and the context of application. Then we just start the media player. Same thing we do for the external sources, for the internet sources. Now, this part we can skip. We do not need this right now. Now there is one thing, another aspect of media player is that you should keep in mind that it is state based. That is, media player has an internal state that you must always be aware of when we are writing your code. Because certain operations are only valid when then player is specific state. That means कि जैसे हमने activity का एक state life cycle पढ़ा था, activity life cycle, there were various states. In the same manner, media player also has various states. Now just look at the state diagram. Now this is the state diagram of our media player. At initially it would be in ideal mode, and we can call reset to make it ideal. Then set data source would initialize it, and prepare async, it just prepares the synchronized, and we can call prepare, that is prepared. But when we call just start, media player.start, it does all these things for us, and our media player is now started. Now again, what we can do, we can stop it, seek to start, or we can just loop. Looping is like keep it playing again and again, again and again. When we call stop, it stopped. From stop, we can again start it, and or when we call pause, like media player dot pause, media is just paused, and we can like replay from here, or we can stop it from here. Also, from started, we can just, once the playback is completed, the playback completed state is called, and from playback completed, we can just start again from the beginning. And we can release the media player resource to end the media playback. Okay. Now, in order to release the media player, a media player can consume valuable system resources. This was what I told you. So we should always take extra precautions to make sure that we are not hanging on to a media player instance longer than necessary. Like as soon as we are done with our media player, we should always call the release method. Now it says हमने क्या किया था, हमने on destroy में किया था, but what Android says, the official documentation, the moment our activity receives a call to on stop, we must release the media player. Okay, so and this is how we release our media player. Now it just again mentions that problem, which was कि अगर हमने मान लो अपनी इसी एप्लीकेशन की स्क्रीन को रोटेट कर दिया तो क्या होता है, हमारा सिस्टम रीस्टार्ट होगा. लाइक हमारी एक्टिविटी रीस्टार्ट होती है, पहले वो क्लोज होती है, पूरी ऑन डिस्ट्रॉय तक जाती है, फिर ऑन क्रिएट होती है. और हमने मान लो मीडिया प्लेयर को रिलीज ही नहीं किया था, वो तो चल रहा है, हमने एक और बार बटन दबा दिया, वो चलता रहेगा. Now since our media player is keeping on running, and let's suppose ki humne sara resource consume kar rakha hai, then it would just say ki we have already created a media player that we did not release, so it would like not at all change the media. मे बी वो उस मीडिया को दोबारा से शुरू करेगा, बट प्रीवियस वन वुड कीप ऑन वर्किंग. लाइक वो चलता ही रहेगा हमारे साथ. आफ्टर दैट देर आर सम अदर थिंग्स, सम एडवांस टॉपिक्स दैट वी डू नॉट नीड टू कीप इन माइंड राइट नाउ. ओके, दैट वी वुड लुक अप व्हेन वी वुड बी गोइंग टू, लाइक इफ एनी वन ऑफ यू वॉन्ट्स टू मेक एन एप्लीकेशन फॉर मीडिया स्ट्रीमिंग, then only you can go for all those methods. Now our task is, let's just check, जब हमने बटन को क्लिक किया then what happened? Guys, there was this problem, like our media player did not stop. Because what happens, when we are, where we are creating our media player resource, we are creating our resource inside our click button. When we are clicking it, then we are creating this resource. This means there was one instance of our media player जो कि चल रहा है. हमने जब स्टॉप किया तो हमारा वो वाला इंस्टेंस तो बंद हो जाएगा, बट उसके पहले ही हम एक नया इंस्टेंस बना चुके हैं. तो लेट्स जस्ट मेक इट हियर इन ऑन क्रिएट. तो जब हमारी एक्टिविटी क्रिएट होती है, अभी हमारे पास हमारे मीडिया प्लेयर का एक इंस्टेंस है, एक ऑब्जेक्ट है मीडिया प्लेयर ऑब्जेक्ट, जिसको एक रिसोर्स एलोकेट कर दिया हमने. आफ्टर दैट लेट अस जस्ट क्लिक दिस बटन. It starts playing. Again, when we click it, now it is paused. Okay? And is it paused or it is stopped? We can know it by writing else if. Not media player dot is playing then we can just do media player dot start. So we just run the application again. Now here our application is up and running. So what we would do, we would just again open the button, close it. Now it is stopped and again play. Now it is not playing because what it says, like an error. Again, let's just try to run it. It again says media player error -38, 0. Now we do not know what is this error. Let's just copy it and search it on Google. Guys, when we get any error in Android, okay, what we should do, like there are certain ways to debug that. The first thing to debug our error is to just read the error. अगर कोई कोडिंग की एरर है तो इट वुड जस्ट गिव अस द लाइन कि कहाँ पे दिक्कत है और क्या दिक्कत है. Now here someone has asked कि he is currently trying to design a simple application that stream an internet radio station. He has an URL of station and I'm setting up the media player like this. Okay, now and he is getting an error. Now the answer is, you just need to call mediaplayer.start in unprepared method by using a listener. You are getting this error because you are calling mediaplayer.start before it has reached the prepared state. Okay. Guys, anyone remember the fallback methods for our media player? Like the callback states, the state diagram. Anyone? Like anyone just remember, मैंने वहां पे एक स्टेट बोली थी, लाइक एक चीज बोली थी स्टेट डायग्राम में कि यहाँ पे है, इफ इट इज इन सर्टेन स्टेट देन वी नीड टू डू समथिंग, इट स्टॉप्ड स्टेट. नाउ अगर ये स्टॉप्ड स्टेट में है ना, जब हम स्टार्ट करते हैं तो यहाँ पे प्रिपेयर्ड कॉल होता है. ये प्रिपेयर्ड तो तब खुद से कॉल हो जाता है जब हम स्टार्ट करते हैं मीडिया प्लेयर डॉट स्टार्ट, बट वंस वी डू स्टॉप, नाउ एट दैट टाइम इट इज इन स्टॉप्ड स्टेट. और पहले जब हमने स्टार्ट किया था तो वो आइडियल से इनिशियलाइज हुआ था, वहां से स्टार्ट, वहां से प्रिपेयर्ड हुआ था. इन दिस लाइफ साइकिल स्टार्ट वुड हैंडल ऑल दिस कॉल्स, बट व्हेन वी स्टॉप इट, तो अभी ये क्या करता है ना, जस्ट लाइक हमने एक गाना बनाया था, हमने इसको एक ऑब्जेक्ट दिया, हमने इसको प्ले किया और फिर छोड़ दिया. लेट सपोज यू हैव अ पेट, योर पेट, लेट सपोज अ डॉग, आपने एक बॉल फेंकी, उसको बोला गो एंड कैच द बॉल, लाइक डॉग ने बॉल को कैच की, अब इसने मुंह में पकड़ा हुआ था बॉल को, और एक मोमेंट पे वंस लाइक योर डॉग हैज कैच द बॉल एंड एट वन मोमेंट, अभी उसने बॉल को मुंह से छोड़ दिया, जब आपने उसको बोला स्टॉप, उसने बॉल को मुंह से नीचे रख दिया. Again, when you give it command to play, that means to get the ball to you. What it would do? First, it would prepare itself to get the ball. मतलब ये ball को वापस से उठाएगा. So what we need to do? Here, we need to call, like after media player dot stop. Either we can call it here only, media player dot prepare, and what it says, unhandled exception java dot io dot io exception. What we can do, either we can just go to our class and we can write throws. It is not accepting it here. So let our method throw this exception. Throws exception. What it says? On click view is an anonymous class derived from on click listener class. Clashes with on click in Android. Overwritten method does not throw. ओके, नाउ व्हाट इट सेज कि जो हमारा ओवररिडन मेथड है, सिंस ऑन क्लिक इज ओवररिडन फॉर फ्रॉम सम पेरेंट क्लास, लाइक फ्रॉम दैट इंटरफेस, ऑन क्लिक इंटरफेस, सो दिस इंटरफेस, दिस डज नॉट हैव दिस एक्सेप्शन. व्हाट वी नीड टू डू, वी नीड टू जस्ट ट्राई टू डू दिस मीडिया प्लेयर प्रिपरेशन, ओके, एंड कैच what it says, IO exception, catch IO exception, and we can just write our it asks us for some identifier, let's just remove it, yahan pe isne ek error de diya. Now it says catch or finally required. Now let Android do the work for us, just hit Alt Enter. Take your cursor here, hit Alt Enter. Now what it says, add catch clause, just add a catch clause. Isne khud hi ek catch clause de diya. Now we are done with it. Let's just run the application again. It is again in running straight. It's in on resume. Let's just click this button. It has started. Click. And again, it started. Then again, when we stop, it stopped. It started. When we close it, और ये बंद हो गया. हमने इसको मल्टीपल टाइम स्टार्ट किया था, बट सिंस वी आर स्टॉपिंग इट एंड वी आर गिविंग इट रिसोर्स ओनली व्हेन इट इज नॉट प्लेइंग, लाइक व्हेन वी डू नॉट हैव एन एक्टिव मीडिया प्लेयर, सो नाउ इट इज क्रिएटिंग ओनली वन इंस्टेंस. नाउ आल्सो टू सेव आवरसेल्फ फ्रॉम दिस एरर एंड ऑल, व्हाट वी कैन डू, वी हैव अनदर मेथड. ओके, लेट्स जस्ट okay, this does not affect our application yet, so let's just run the application once again and let me show you one more thing. Guys, just listen to this music carefully. The music has started. It has paused to somewhere where the note is going from low pitch to high pitch. Now let's just restart it. Yahan pe kya hua, abhi hamara music इसको जिस जगह से जाना था, लाइक अभी यू रिमेंबर व्हाट इज द स्टेट एंड फ्रॉम वेयर इट शुड स्टार्ट, हमने रोका कहाँ पे था. व्हेन वी प्ले इट अगेन, ये वहीं से नहीं प्ले होता. व्हाट हैपेंस कि ये स्टार्टिंग से दोबारा प्ले होता है. नाउ वी डू नॉट नीड दिस फंक्शनैलिटी फॉर आर पॉज बटन, लाइक जो हमारा प्ले बटन होता है, एक बार प्ले करने के बाद वी जस्ट चेंज दिस बटन ओनली टू अवर पॉज बटन. अग्रीड? So what we should have कि like हमारा music वहाँ पे ही stop होने के बजाय रुक जाना चाहिए और वहीं से start होना चाहिए. Do we need this functionality or not? Guys, please respond in chat. Do we need this functionality only or we need something else? Okay, should we should our music stop and start playing again, or should it like play again from where? Yashika, you have a button which plays your music. Once it is playing, we need to, you just stopped it again, like you just press that button again. Now what would you want? Would you want your music to start again when you try to reopen it, or would you start it to continue? Okay, you are saying it should start from beginning. Amit says it should continue. Yashika, in all the music players, we have the button. जो play का button होता है वो हमेशा pause button में change होता है. Okay, and we have a separate stop button. For that functionality, what we are doing, we are just abruptly closing, like we are stopping it from resume. Abhishek says from resume it should start. Abhishek, I did not get you, what you are trying to say, like from which resume, like the resume callback method, or resume is the method of media player? Okay, yes, it should resume from where we have stopped it. So for that, we do not need to do media player dot stop. What we can do it instead, we can just do media player dot pause and stop. We can do add to functionality of some other button which is really responsible for stopping our media. Now we just play it again. Now the application is running. Let's just play it. We just paused it, and when we start it, it is just continue. Now if we want to add a more functionality so that it is stopped and it starts playing again, then we can just call on stop method, and then we can prepare re-prepare our media player in the click listener of some other button. Okay guys, is it clear to everyone? Guys, is it clear to everyone? Yes. Okay, any doubts? Like, these are the basic methods. We are left with one more thing. What we read on the developers.android.com documentation is we should release our media player in our on stop callback. So in just on stop, we should just release the media player. So this is all that we have to do about media player. We just need to know how to create an object, how to pass and resource to that object, and how to just play it, how to pause it, how to stop and restart, and how to release the resources. Now you can just go on the internet, you can browse the media player library. It has a lot of method, like it gives you what is the total play time of the media that you are playing, what is the current time stamp at which like kitni der tak ka gana play ho chuka hai, kitni der ka bacha hai. There are a lot of methods. You can browse it and you can apply it and test it as your wish. So we are done with this application. Now we would be starting our new topic. That is collections. Okay, so now for that, let us just open our score application again. Okay, it says the path has changed, no issues. File. We need to just open. Just open the score application. Let's open it in a new window. Okay guys, how many of you have added the functionality to your wicket buttons? Like, I asked you to add a functionality when you click your wicket buttons. So what should happen in that application ki jo humne instance banaya tha players ke liye, like jo unka score tha or the number of balls they have played, it should reset to zero. How many of you have done that? Yeah, Yashika, not done. So do we need database functionality to play audio from my phone playlist? No. Amit, you do not need database functionalities to play audio from your phone's playlist. If you are adding a media player to your application, like this application, it had a media player. You can just code it in a way so that okay, Yashika, only your score is getting zero. My number of balls is not getting zero. Okay, not a problem. Today, what we would do, we would change this to a model class. Okay, and because now the target we are aiming at, okay, we should be having a list of 11 players who would come and bat. We are not going to change the baller right now, or we can have two ballers. Okay, let's just have two ballers, and we can have we should have 11 batsmen, and all these batsmen would have their scores, separate scores. And once we are done with this, once the inning is over, what we should do, like, we should just display the score, or we should have a button that would just display the score on a list view in another activity. Like, we would create another activity, would create a list view over there, And in this list view, we would be displaying the score of every player, like one player, how much balls he had played and what he has scored. For that, let's just today we would just do the preparation part. We would just prepare our application to like have the list view and other things, like so that it can just display it to the list view. Now we have P1 score, P2 score, then overs is 0, balls C, ball S1, balls 2 means balls of player 1, balls of player 2. Okay, now guys, in order to minimize the number of variables, the number of integer variables we are having, since these variables are property of our players, what we can do, okay, guys, this is an error which you would get, like the installation failed with message invalid file F programs Android Studio score at the. It is possible that this issue is resolved by uninstalling existing version of APK file if present and then reinstalling. Okay, this is an error that you would encounter when like you have changed your path. Like pehle project kahin aur installed tha, it was somewhere else in some other directory. I changed the directory structure. I moved the project from there to somewhere else. But hota kya jab hum pehli baar apna application build karte hain na, to ye kuch APK files banata hai hamare liye. It creates some slice APKs, jo ki slices mein install hoti hain hamare devices pe, hamare target devices pe, jab hum usko run karte hain application ko. So when we just change it and we are trying to install our new slices, now it is not getting the previous slices, so that it would not like fir jo naya APK hai na, it does not identify it and it throws an error that I had an APK of this path and I am not getting the new APK for the same path. And also your application, it is passing it some APKs of your old path and which are not matching with your path. So what you need to do, either you just go build and just clean the project, or you just try rebuilding the project and it would like solve your problem. Our first target should be rebuilding the project. Check it again. If it solves the issue, it's well and good. Otherwise, we should go for clean and then rebuild. Now let's just run it again and just see what happens. Now we can see the application is up and running. So what we need to do, like hum isko ek player ka instance bana sakte hain. We can make Dhoni a player, Kohli a player. It can have two variables. First one is how many balls he has played and second is how many runs he has scored. So we can like then in our application we can remove four variables with just one object of class. So let's just go to this Java file and create new class file, new Java class. We can name it as player. Guys, since it is a class, it should not have any super class. And since we intend to send its objects using intents, so it we can add a serializable method for now. But later on, it would not require serializable because we would be using array lists, and we would be passing those array lists when we would be like adding the list views. Now we can just hit OK, and it would create a class for us. We can have its members private string. Player name. Okay. Private int core. Private int balls played. Now let's just make a constructor that would initialize the values for our player. We should pass and like should receive a string name. It should again receive an integer that should be the score, and an integer for balls played. Then it should just check. It should now set this dot player name should be equal to the player name. The score that we have received, we should set it to the score. And then the number of balls played should be set to this dot balls played. Okay, now we need getter methods for all these three variables, player name, score and balls played. And our intention is to change okay, now our intention is to change the state of this player, like change the score and change the balls played after every ball has been played. So we need the setter methods for that. Now we need to generate it. Just go to generate getters and setters. We need getter and setter. Let's generate it for all these three methods. Sorry, all these three variables. Now it has three getters: getter, setter, getter, setter, and getter, setter. Now just come to main activity. Now here we can have a string array. String players equal to, now let's just add 11 players here. That's Shikhar. Then we have Rohit. After Rohit, what we have? Now we have Virat. After that, let's add After Rahul, let's just we've added four now. Fifth should be Tony. After that, there would be Hardik. Okay. After that, the seventh player. Okay, let's add Mr. Kedar Jadhav here. Then there comes the bowlers. Okay, you guys just name in the chat. I would just copy and I would just paste it. Bhuvi. Bumrah, and then we have Chahal. Now let's just see how many players we've added. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. Now we have all our 11 players. Okay. Now what we can do? We can remove P1S from here. We can remove P2S. Then we can remove balls 1 and we can remove balls 2. Now what we need, here an object of our player class and we need two players. So we can have here player. P1, but it says cannot resolve symbol player, as there might be some like conflict, so just name it players so that there is no conflict in the name. Okay. We need to rename the class as well to players.java. Just refactor it. Just rename the file to players.java. Now here we can write players P1 and P2. It says cannot resolve symbol players. We can just rebuild it. And now it would be identifying our players resource, our players class. Okay, now what we have to do in the onCreate method, it says compilation failed because we are having okay guys, the issue here is ki hamari jo file honi chahiye wo yahan pe honi chahiye com.example.android.score@da, but ye hai kahan pe? It is under the test. We should just move it from package or adda to this folder. Now what it says to package com.example.enter.store.adda, just refactor it. Okay, now it is here. And now it has identified it P1 and P2. Guys, abhi hame kya chahiye? Hame abhi do players ke instance chahiye, do objects. So let's just make player 1 and player 2. Creating the instance for the current current players, and what we need to do, now here hame banana hai player sorry p1 equal to new players. For our first player we can name it as let's just change this to team to avoid the name conflicts. Okay, now what we need to do, teams zeroth index, after that we have to pass the score, it should be 0, and the balls played, it should be 0. We created it for our first player. Let's create it for second player as well. P2 is equal to new player. Team is equal to like team 1. Now we have two players which are batting. Hum yahan pe kya karte the, hume P1 ka score dena tha aur balls played by player 1. We can replace it by P1 dot get score and balls should be replaced by p1 dot get balls played. Same here, p2 dot get score and p2 dot get balls played. In order to resolve some conflicts, maybe aisa ho ki humne isko use pehle kiya, define baad mein kiya. Though it would not give us an error, but then also we should like define it before these views. Let's just define it before all the views. Now also to keep track of ki humne kitna travel kar liya apne is array mein se. Let's just have an integer pointer, int team pointer, okay, int team pointer equal to 01. Now we need to have a team pointer at either 1 or 2. Let's just keep it at 1. When a player would be adding, we would increase the pointer and then we would create instance of another player. Okay, now again what we need to do, we need to change the p1 as to p1 dot p1 dot set score. Okay, it was the player one's score p1s. So what we need to do? P1 dot set score. It should be added 6 here. Either what we can do कि हम यहाँ पे एक ऐसा method में यहाँ पे हम सिर्फ 6 को डाल दें और वो यहाँ पे आके players dot java में जब हमारा setter है और this dot score it should just give us plus equal to score, okay, and we can just pass this 6 here. Or what we can do, p1 dot we can add p1 dot get score plus 6. Both these things are correct, whichever suits us. We would be using whichever suits you, you can use it. I would prefer using second one for now. If we like get any error, we would just switch back to this method. Now we have to change the balls played by player one. So we should change this player one dot set balls played. Now again we need to have p1 dot get balls played plus 1. Again here we would have to write p1 dot get score and p1 dot get balls played. Again P2S plus 6 karna hai. Let's just copy this line. Let's just paste it over here. And P1 ko P2 karte hai. Again, hume balls 2 ko karna tha. So let's just copy this line. And let's just replace it. And change P1 with P2. Okay, everyone getting what we are doing? Anyone have any doubts? P1 dot get score. P1 dot get balls played. ओके यहाँ पे हमें सारा P1 वाला कोड ही कॉपी करना है. इधर आ जाओ, P1 वाले कोड पे बस रन और टीम के स्कोर में 6 की जगह हमें 4 ऐड करना है. सो लेट्स जस्ट कॉपी दिस एंटायर कोड, लेट्स जस्ट रिप्लेस दिस. ओके हियर जस्ट पास 4 इंस्टेड ऑफ 6. Again, just do the same. Let's just come back to P1S again and let's just do it. Sorry. Okay, Control V. For 6, we need to add 3 now. And here also, okay, here in team score, we have to add 3. Again, let's just go for P1 ka 2 hai. Let's just paste it. And here we need to add 2. Similarly, for team score, we have to add 2. Now we are in one more method. Just do it 2. And again, do it 2. Guys, everyone is getting all of this. Like if anyone has any doubts, just please ask. Okay, great. Suryadev, what about you? Okay, he just left the class. Okay, so we have settled all for like our scores. Now let's just copy the code for P2 and let's just make the same changes, and then we would just run the application to see what is happening. Like copy it. Four, and here also four. Three and we should again write three here. After that, for this two. And two. Plus one. Plus one. And plus zero. And plus zero. Now let's just run this application and see what are the changes that we have done. Okay guys, the application is up and running here. Till now we have not like हमने नाम नहीं चेंज किया था, बस हमने जो बेसिक फंक्शनलिटी है उसको क्लास के लाइक यूज्ड मॉडल क्लास फॉर दैट. वी आर क्लिकिंग दीज बटन्स, दीज आर वर्किंग फाइन फॉर अस. ओके या ओके ऑन सिक्स इट इज शोइंग प्लेयर टू द स्कोर. ठीक है, फोर थ्री टू वन जीरो विकेट. फॉर पी टू इट इज नॉट शोइंग अस द करेक्ट थिंग. लेट्स गो टू द कोड फॉर पी टू. ओके वी आर शोइंग योर पी वन डॉट गेट स्कोर. वी नीड टू फॉर जीरो चेक. वी नीड टू गेट हियर P2 dot score and P2 dot get balls played. Okay, like when we copied it, we did not change it properly. Now let's just add P2 everywhere. That is why हम कुछ भी कर रहे थे तो हमारे पास जो स्कोर आ रहा था वो सिर्फ P1 का आ रहा था. जो हमने 17 runs player 1 ने बनाए थे, it was giving us the same. Okay. P2 and P2. P2 score and P2 score. Okay, we did a mistake. हमने अभी P1 यहाँ पे P1 देना है, P2 देना है, फिर अगेन हेयर वुड बी P1, देन अगेन P2, देन अगेन हेयर शुड बी P1. गाइस एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू ऑल? देन अगेन हेयर शुड बी P2, देन अगेन वी हैव टू डू P1 डॉट स्कोर हेयर. And for this, we have to write P2 dot. Then again, it is for P1, it is for our player 2. Okay, again for player 1, and the last one for player 2. Now, let's just go to our main file and just add ID for the first name. It is now text view ID player 1. For the second player, for Kohli, let's just add an ID of player underscore 2. So that we can change the name of players. Now we need to have two more text views. Let's add P1's name and P2's name. Now here we are creating instance of views. So let's just create the instances P1 name is equal to find text view by ID r dot ID dot player 1. Now let's just duplicate the line for player 2. P2 name is equal to r dot ID dot player name and player underscore player underscore 2. Okay, so here is one spelling mistake. It should be name and player 2 name. Now what we need to do, we need to set the names as well. P1 name dot set text. What we need to set here is p1 dot get player name. Similarly for p2 name, we have to set p2 dot get player name. Now let's just run the application and see the changes. Okay, now our application is running. Now here, Dhoni and Virat has been replaced with Shikhar and Rohit. Here 6, 6, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. There is no click action for this button yet. So for 6, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Again 0, 1. Now it is working fine. Now what we need to do? Let's just button 12. Till button 12, I have done. Now we have two more buttons, button wicket 1 and button wicket 2. Let's just add click listeners for these buttons as well. Wicket 1 dot set on click listener new on click listener. Now in the on click method, what we have to do? Now we have to just change the player. We had an instance of player, an object for player named Shikhar Dhawan, an object for रोहित शर्मा. नाउ शिखर धवन आउट होता है तो हमें उसकी जगह पे विराट कोहली को लाना है. नाउ हाउ विराट कोहली कैन कम, इधर वी कैन रिप्लेस लाइक वी कैन रीसेट ऑल द वेरिएबल्स फॉर द सिंगल इंस्टेंस ऑफ शिखर धवन. लाइक जो हमने P1 बनाया था, प्लेयर P1 इक्वल टू एंड द न्यू प्लेयर वी पास देयर शिखर धवन 0 एंड 0. वी कैन रीराइट दैट कोड, इससे फिर वो रीसेट हो जाएगा. Okay, or the second thing that we can do, we can make another player like this player players p3 equal to new player new player, and we can pass the player name. The player name would be team, I plus one. What it says? It says cannot resolve symbol I. We've given int team pointer 1. Instead of I, we need to rewrite team pointer. Team pointer plus 1. We have passed the name, then we need to pass the score 0 and again 0. And now we have to do team pointer plus plus. Okay, again, what we need to do, we need to just show players player one's name and their scores. Overs jaisa tha waisa hi rahega. Sorry, over count aur ball count bhi badhega, and similarly wo player one aur player two ke liye bhi wo cheeze badhengi. Okay, so let's just copy it for like player one ka naam show karna hai aur player one ka hi score bhi show karna hai. So let's just copy this line. Now we have to do it here. Okay, p1 dot name set p1 dot. Now what we have to do here, we have to use p3. And again, we have to set, we have to display these things as well. P1 score and balls played. We have to just copy it. And we have to just paste it. But guys, before this, humne ek cheez chhod di ki humne sirf naya player bana diya, us player ko out kar diya. But humne kya kiya? Balls ka count nahi badhaya hai. What we have to do? We have to increase number of balls. The score would not get increased, so we should just not write add 0 again. We can just skip this statement. Okay, then we have to do this line and we have to just do it till here, and we have to do all this for P1. Guys, now we can see one thing ki hume since Shikhar ke liye uska score alag se store karke rakhna hai uske out hone ke baad bhi. So what we did, humne okay, now let's just run the application and then I will talk about this test case. ओके तो द एप्लीकेशन इज हियर, लेट्स जस्ट सीधे आउट कर देते हैं. आउट हो गया, यहाँ विराट इज हियर. फिर से आउट करेंगे, देयर इज राहुल. अगेन हमने आउट किया, नाउ देयर इज धोनी, हार्दिक, बुमराह, केदार, बेनभूवी. ओके इवन स्कोर बुमराह. देयर इज वन मिस्टेक वी हैव डन कि हमने जो बॉल्स प्लेड है, इवन डॉट बॉल्स प्लेड, हमने उसको चेंज नहीं किया है. हैव वी डिस्प्लेड इन द स्टार्टिंग. ओके पी वन डॉट स्कोर, पी टू डॉट स्कोर, हियर स्कोर, ओवर्स. ओके ना, हमें यहाँ पे क्या करना है, हमें P1 की जगह पे स्कोर और बॉल्स प्लेड लिखना है P3 का. नाउ लेट्स जस्ट रन दिस एप्लीकेशन अगेन एंड जस्ट सी व्हाट द चेंजेस हैड बीन डन. नाउ इट हैज सम स्कोर, इट हैज प्लेड 2 balls, 3 balls, इट हैज स्कोर 13 रन. नाउ इट गॉट आउट. Now Virat Kohli comes 0 balls. 1, 2, 3 balls. Okay. And again, ये out हुआ. Again, ये out हो गया. Rahul comes. यहाँ पे फिर से इसको 9 balls दिखा रहा है. एंड स्कोर वहां पे ऐड हो रहा है. दिस इज बिकॉज कि हमने सिर्फ विकेट गिरने में प्लेयर चेंज किया, नया प्लेयर बनाया. बट इन ऑल दीज मेथड्स जहां पे स्कोर बढ़ता है, हम अभी भी P1 के ऑब्जेक्ट में ही चेंज करा रहे हैं. नाउ हमें एक नया ऑब्जेक्ट बनाना है विराट कोहली के लिए और फॉर एनी अपकमिंग प्लेयर. बिकॉज अगर हम पुराने ऑब्जेक्ट में ही डेटा को चेंज कर देंगे, लाइक अगर हमने P1 में ही नेम को विराट कोहली कर दिया, बाकी चीजों को रीसेट कर दिया, देन गाइस जो प्रॉब्लम हम फेस करेंगे दैट वुड बी कि हमारे साथ इशू क्या आएगा कि जब हमारा एम क्या है, हमारा एम है इंडिविजुअल प्लेयर का स्कोर इनिंग्स ओवर होने के बाद हम एक लिस्ट व्यू में दिखा पाए. उस लिस्ट व्यू में जाने के लिए हमें सारे प्लेयर्स का ऑब्जेक्ट होना चाहिए हमारे पास. नाउ वी हैव 2 options. ईदर वी राइट मल्टीपल लाइक 11 इफ एल्स फॉर ईच ऑफ दीज मेथड्स. जाके देखेंगे इफ लाइक करंट प्लेयर्स पॉइंटर इज दिस, तो P1 में स्कोर करना है. अगर वो बढ़ गया है तो P2 में बढ़ाना है. अगर वो बढ़ गया है तो P3 में करना है एंड सो ऑन. और what we can do, we can simply like यहाँ पे P1 out हुआ, उसकी हमने balls को save की. Now we can declare an array list. How many of you know what is an array list? Come on guys, any response? I would just give you the concept of what we have to do and then we would just end the class for today. Okay, any more answer? Anyone else who knows what is an array list? There's Abhishek, Amit, Mitesh. What about you guys? Do you know what is an array list? Okay, Abhishek, you also know what is an array list? What about others? Mitesh and Amit? Amit also knows. Mitesh, what about you? Okay, so guys, array list is a collection in Java that stores object. It is like a generic collection that stores generic type of objects or any generic data. So what we can do, like array list. Now we have to give the type of what we have to store. We have to store object of players. We can have it as players equal to new. Okay, we can just write it till here. And in an on create, हम इसको यहाँ पे instantiate कर सकते हैं. Instantiating the array list. sorry guys. Now here we can just write players is equal to new array list and that's all. p1.new array list. We can just define players here, or we can ignore it as well, but we can write, it's good if we write it so that there is no conflict. So now what we can do, we can just do here, humne changes kar liye. Now players dot add, and we have to pass an object of players, that is our p1. ठीक है, हमने p1 को यहाँ पे पास कर दिया. अगेन हमने क्या किया, नया ऑब्जेक्ट बनाने के बजाय हमने अपने p1 को न्यू प्लेयर्स बना दिया, टीम का 0 0 0. ओके, एंड नाउ हियर वी डू इट फॉर p1, वी डू इट फॉर p1 एंड वी डू इट फॉर p1. Okay, it is done. Let's just run the application. Now it is Shikhar. 0, 1 balls, 2 balls, 3 balls, 4 balls, and he gets out on the 5th ball. Virat aata hai. Abhi ek ball pe 6 run khela hai isne. 2 balls, 3 balls, 4 balls. Again, one more ball. Now 2 overs, he gets out. Guys, you can notice one thing. अभी यहाँ पे ना ये 2.1 आ रहा है, नहीं आ रहा है. जब ये out होता है तो यहाँ पे overs का जो count है, balls का जो count था, हमारा ये चीज सही से डिस्प्ले नहीं हो रही, बिकॉज हम ये ओवर्स वाला जो सेट टेक्स्ट है और जो टीम स्कोर वाला है, हमने इस चीज को अभी तक यहाँ पे इम्प्लीमेंट नहीं किया. सो व्हाट इज योर टास्क टुडे, जस्ट गो हियर, जस्ट ऐड विकेट्स प्लस प्लस, ओके, जस्ट अपडेट द टीम स्कोर एंड अपडेट द ओवर्स. And add the same functionality for P2. Tomorrow, what we will do? We will just add a check कि हम देखेंगे कि 11 से ज़्यादा players का instance ना बने, या तो balls खत्म हो गई, 50 overs हो गए, या players हमारे पूरे हो गए, तो हमारी innings over हो जाएगी. और जैसे ही हमारी innings over होगी, तो we will make a list view. We will send an intent to an activity. That would have our list view, and on that list view we would just display the score. With this, ending the session for today. I hope you have understood it well. If you have any doubts, just ask your doubts either on Slack or on WhatsApp. Okay, good night guys. See you all in tomorrow's session.